Hello, Internet. I'm Matt Haas. This is Awesome Wood Things. I am building a plywood CNC machine. This machine is called Gatton CNC. This guy sells it for a few hundred bucks. He'll give you the precision milled pieces, and you buy a bunch of extra parts and build the gantry and the bed yourself because those are just straight cuts. And boom, you've got an awesome CNC machine. I'll show you the techniques. You should also follow Dave's instructions on his playlist. That's the official build instructions. Mine is going to be fast-paced to give you an idea of all the different things that are needed to cut and attach all the parts together. It's going to be a fun ride. Make sure you're subscribed. Okay, here we go.
On top of the V-Box assembly is a spacer and the stepper motor. And the stepper motor will spin this Acme rod, and that will force the entire box up and down. I use a center finding bit to start each one of these holes. These need to be drilled completely out to accept some T-nuts later on. And those T-nuts need to sit flush, so a Forstner bit is used. I drill pilot holes everywhere else. There's these little indentations from the template. And on the opposite side, a countersink. Then I drill pilot holes and drive screws everywhere. I don't always show the pilot hole drilling, but it's done. Make sure everything's straight and flush, and you'll be good to go. The bottom piece, I did not install. This helps the Acme rod stay in place at the bottom of the Z-Box. I use a chop saw to cut the aluminum angle. Yes, you can cut aluminum with woodworking tools. It's kind of crazy, but that can certainly be done. I drill pilot holes and then countersink them to accept some wood screws, which I'll attach here. A slightly longer wood screw goes on this one because I have more material to bite into. That is an inch. And then 3/4 inch wood screws are used where there's only one board underneath. Now this will be referred to as the Z-Box assembly. Drop a like and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks, Internet.